ఇంటర్మీడియట్ విద్యా రంగంలో అగ్రగామి మన ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ ఐఐటి జేఈఈ అయినా నీట్ అయినా తిరుగులేని విద్యా సంస్థ ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్.
నెక్స్ట్ బ్రాంచ్ ఇస్ నెక్స్ట్ సబ్ బ్రాంచ్ ఆఫ్ జువాలజీ ఇస్ మార్ఫాలజీ. What is the meaning of morphos? Means form. Morphos means form. Form means what is the external appearance of an individual, whether it is human like, whether it is cat like, whether it is a dog like, whether it is rabbit like, that is nothing but morphos, external appearance of an individual. External appearance of individual is nothing but form. Again, logy means study, means external form of an individual is said to be as the morphology. Morphology does not only consider the external form of an individual, then what is the form of an individual, what is the size of an individual, what is the color of an individual, and how the internal organs maybe gets arranges, where the kidney is located, where the heart is located, where the digestive system is located, this entire information is gets dealt by morphology branch. Definitely morphology always deals with the form of an individual, size of an individual, color of an individual, shape of an individual. Definitely it always concerned with the form of an individual, size of an individual, color of an individual, shape of an individual, and also how the internal organs may be gets arranges, also dealt by morphology. This morphology is principally with two sub branches. One is the external morphology. External morphology. Second branch is internal morphology. Definitely morphology is with the two sub branches. One is said to be as the external morphology, second one is said to be as the internal morphology. External morphology always considered only external characters of an individual. External morphology always considered only external characters of an individual. External characters means what is size of body, what is the color of body, what is the shape of body, what is the external form of body. Whether it is with the dark color, whether it is with the bright color, whether it is short, whether it is with the height, whether its body is rounded or its oval in shape, like that way, only if we can consider the external characters of an individual, then that branch is said to be as the external morphology. External morphology always considered external form of body, external size of body, external color of body, external shape of the body. Then how the question may be framed on this particular concept means, how the question may be asked on this particular concept means, in our country the marriage system is mainly depends upon this kind of the branch, we can say emphasizedly, because definitely by basing external form of the body only marriages are going on in our country. So definitely external morphology is the principal branch. It is principally concerned with the external size of body, external color of body, external shape of body, external form of the body. Next to internal morphology, internal morphology always concerned with internal arrangement of organs, with internal organs color, with internal organs shape, with internal organs size. Means definitely inside of body, whatever the kidney is present, that is with the dark red in color, that is with the kidney in shape, that is bean shape. Whatever the duodenum which is present, that is a U in shape. Whatever the stomach which is present, that is a J in shape. Like that way, internal organs are with different colors, internal organs are with different shapes, internal organs are with different sizes. So to betterly explain all this internal organs related information, this internal morphology principally helps to us to betterly identify the shape of an organ, size of an organ, color of an internal organ, what is the branch which is a lot useful to us, means internal morphology. To betterly say the shape of stomach is J in shape, shape of the duodenum is U in shape, shape of the uterus is inverted pyramid shape, to betterly say what is the branch which is a lot helpful to us means that is the internal morphology. Definitely it always concerned with the size, color, shape of internal organs. How that kind of the internal organs are gets arranges, what is the size of the internal organ, what is the color of internal organ, what is the shape of internal organ, to betterly explain this internal morphology branch is a lot useful to us. Again, in internal morphology, two sub branches are there. One is the cytology, second one is the anatomy. Definitely, again in internal morphology, there are two sub branches. One is the cytology, second one is the anatomy. What is the cytology means? Cytos means a cell. Loci means steady. Cytos means a cell. Loci means study. The detailed study of a cell. Detailed study of a cell is said to be as the cytology. Means, what is the size of the cell? What is the shape of the cell? What is the color of the cell? With respect to cell, if we can want to explain, if we want to explain the size of the cell, color of the cell, shape of the cell, what is the branch of the zoology which is a lot helpful to us? Means cytology. So definitely cytology always deals the form of the cell, means what is the shape of the cell, what is the color of the cell, what is the size of the cell, to betterly explain size, shape, color of various cells, this branch is a lot useful to us here. Definitely this cytology branch always deals form of cell, size of cell, again color of cell. So definitely with respect to size, color and external appearance of a cell, definitely what is the branch which is helpful to us? Means cytology. Anatomy. Definitely this cytology is also called as microanatomy. Cytology branch is also called as microanatomy. Cytology branch is also called as the microanatomy. Then what is the anatomy means? Internal arrangement of organs. Internal arrangement of organs and organ systems study is said to be as the anatomy. For example, what are the layers which are present in the wall of the stomach? How they may be arranged? To betterly know what is the branch, to betterly understand what is the branch which is a lot helpful to us, means that is the anatomy branch. Anatomy nothing but it is the branch of zoology that deals the internal arrangement of the organs in a specific manner. Anatomy is the branch of zoology. It deals internal arrangement of organs, means how the stomach is formed, what are the layers which are present in the stomach wall, how the heart is gets a form, how many number of the layers are present in the heart wall, like this, to betterly understand the transverse section of the wall of the heart, transverse section of the wall of the stomach, what is the branch which is a lot helpful to us, means that is the anatomy branch. Means internal arrangement of an organ is principally dealed by a branch that is said to be as the anatomy. Means anatomy always useful to betterly understand what are the layers which are present in the stomach, what are the layers which are present in the heart. Means definitely by taking transverse section of wall of the stomach, if we can observe in wall, four layers are very clearly appears. Outermost layer is the serosa, Again, middle layer is muscular. Next layer is muscularis. Next layer is submucosa. Next layer is mucosa. Definitely, if we can take a transverse section from the wall of the stomach, if we can keep it under electron microscope, if we can observe that, definitely four distinct layers are gets appears in the wall of the stomach. What are the layers in a sequence from outer to inner means? Serosa, muscularis, submucosa, mucosa. Means to betterly understand this transverse section of the stomach wall, what is the branch of the zoology which is a lot helpful to us? Means anatomy. To betterly understand the wall of the stomach, to betterly understand the wall of the heart, to betterly understand the wall of the uterus, what is the branch of the biology which is a lot helpful to us? Means that is the anatomy branch. Means anatomy is useful to principally observe. Anatomy is principally helpful to us to observe the layers which may be arranges in a given respective organ. How that kind of the respective organ is made up of? How many number of the layers are involved in the formation of a respective organ? How they may be arranged in a sequence? To betterly known this detailed information of a organ, what is the branch which is helpful to us? Means that is the anatomy. Then on this particular concept, how the question may be framed in NEET examination point of view means, how the question may be asked on this particular morphology concept means, if a student wants to know the structure of ovary, then which branch of zoology he have to then which branch of zoology helps to him if a student wants to know the structure of ovary, then which branch of zoology helps to him is the question. Definitely, ovary is the internal organ, like that of the stomach, like that of the heart, like that of the uterus. Ovary is a internal organ. So to betterly understand the structure of internal organ, the transverse sections of internal organ, what is the branch of zoology which is helpful to us? Means anatomy. So for example, first option, if they give as a taxonomy, second option, anatomy, third option, genetics, fourth option, all. In this question, Which is the correct answer? What is the branch which is a lot helpful to us to betterly understand internal organs structure? Means that is nothing but anatomy. Anatomy always deals the internal structures of organs and internal arrangement of organs also. How that kind of the internal organs are gets arranges and what is the structure of that organ, what is the shape of that kind of the organ, what is the form of that kind of the organ is dealt by the anatomy. So here the question is that if a student wants to know the structure of the ovary, then which branch of zoology helps to him? Means that is nothing but anatomy branch. Anatomy always concerned for detailed study of internal organ structures and also for detailed study of internal organs arrangement. This anatomy branch is a lot helpful to us. This is the morphology branch. Next branch is physiology. Next branch is physiology. Next branch of zoology is the physiology. What is the meaning of physios? In physiology, what is the meaning of physios? Means body functions. Physios nothing but body functions. Again, logos means study. Various body functions study is said to be as the physiology. What are the various body functions which may be performed in our body? Digestion is body function. Respiration is body function. Excretion is body function. Circulation is body function. Body movement is body function. Like that way, detailed study about various body functions is said to be as the physiology. For example, study of digestion, because this is the one body function. Respiration is one body function. Circulation is one body function. Excretion is one body function. Movement is one body function. Like that way, to betterly understand the various body functions of an individual, what is the branch of biology which is a lot helpful to us? Means that is the physiology. Physiology branch a lot helpful to us to betterly understand how the various body functions may be performed in the body of an individual. How the various body functions may be gets performed in the body of an individual to betterly know what is the branch of zoology which is a lot helpful to us? Means that is the physiology. Then how the question may be framed on this particular concept? Means how the question may be framed on this particular concept? Means If a student wants to know, if a student wants to know mechanism of mechanism of muscle contraction, if a student wants to know mechanism of muscle contraction, then If a student wants to know mechanism of muscle contraction, branch helps to him in zoology is the question. Then first option, anatomy. Second option, morphology. Third option, physiology. Fourth option, taxonomy. Fourth option is taxonomy. Then which is the correct one for this question means? Mechanism of muscle contraction is one body function. Definitely, whenever the muscles are gets contracted, then only movement is taking place in the body. For occurring of the movement, definitely muscle must be gets contracted. Contraction and relaxation is responsible for movement of an individual. Contraction and relaxation of muscle is responsible for bringing up the movement of an organ. So definitely muscle contraction is one body function. To betterly known mechanism of muscle contraction, that is the one type of the body function, which branch of zoology is a lot helpful to us means definitely that is the physiology branch. Physiology branch a lot helpful to us to betterly understand how that kind of the muscle contraction may be taken place in the body, how that may be useful for bringing up the movement of an organ, whether that may be forelimb or hind limbs. This movement of forelimb as well as hind limb must be bring out by the contraction and relaxation of that muscle only. So that only, definitely if a student wants to know mechanism of muscle contraction, then which branch helps to him in zoology means that is nothing but physiology branch a lot helpful to us to betterly understand that mechanism of the muscle contraction. Next branch is embryology and developmental biology. Next branch is embryology and developmental biology. Then at first you have to know what is the embryology, what is the developmental biology means. From the day of formation of zygote to delivery of baby, whatever the events which may be taken place inside of the womb of the mother, such each and every event study is said to be as the embryology. Here embryos means embryo, again logos means study. Definitely detailed study about embryo, detailed study about embryo is said to be as the embryology. That's nothing but from the day of formation of zygote to delivery, whatever the developmental activities which may be going on in embryo in order to reach to infant, such all events of study is said to be as the embryology. For example, due to the fusion of a sperm cell with the ovum, this is the sperm cell, this is ova, sperm cell is fused with the ova to form the zygote. Definitely due to the fertilization of the sperm with ovum or ova, diploid state of zygote is formed here. Here zygote is formed here. Later zygote will be developed into morula. That will be developed into blastula. That will be developed into gastrula. That will be developed into embryo. Finally, infant is delivered, or that is simply we can say fetus. This is nothing but fetus is delivered. From the day of formation of zygote, to the delivery of fetus, all events which may be occurs inside of the womb of the mother, all such events study is said to be as the embryology. Detailed study of embryo or from the formation of zygote to delivery of the fetus, whatever the intermediate events which may be occurs, all such events detailed study is dealt by embryology branch. Embryology branch always deals the detailed study of embryonic development from the day of formation of zygote to delivery of the fetus. Next, developmental biology also deals the developmental activities of embryo as well as after delivery, whatever the developmental activities which are occurs during the life of the person till the death. Means after the delivery, whatever the developmental activities which are occurs in the person till the death, all such developmental activities or studies collectively called as the developmental biology. You should remember here, developmental biology not only deal the developmental activities in child after delivery up to the death, but also deals the developmental activities during the embryonic development also. Means developmental biology deals the developmental activities from the day of formation of zygote to death of the person. Death of the person, but not up to the delivery of the fetus. All events which may be occurs from the formation of zygote to delivery of the fetus, all such events detailed study is nothing but embryology. But developmental biology deals all the events from the formation of zygote to the death of the person, whatever the developmental activities which may be going on, such all events detailed study is nothing but developmental biology. Means what I am saying here, that what is the difference between the embryology and developmental biology, means embryology only deals the events from the formation of zygote to the delivery of the fetus only. But developmental biology deals all the events from the formation of the zygote to death of the person. Means it also deals the events of embryonic development. After the delivery, whatever the developmental activities which are occurs in the person during his lifetime, up to the death, all such kind of the events also dealt by the developmental biology. Embryology deals the developmental events from the day of formation of zygote to the delivery only. But developmental biology deals all the events which may be occurs from the zygote to the delivery, as well as after delivery during the life of the person, whatever the developmental events are occurs till the death, also dealt by developmental biology. Finally, I want to conclude one important point. Embryology is part of developmental biology, because both embryology as well as developmental biology, both of them deals events from the day of formation of zygote to the delivery. In addition to this, after delivery, whatever the events which are occurs in the life of the person, whatever the developmental activities which are occurs in the life of the person, they are dealt only by the developmental biology. Means definitely we can say one important point: embryology and developmental biology definitely both of them deals all the events from the day of formation of zygote to the delivery of the fetus. But after the delivery, whatever the development which is occurs in the person till the death, that is only dealt by the developmental biology. So that only we can say embryology is part of developmental biology. Embryology is part of developmental biology. In that way, embryology principally deals all the events which are occurs during the embryonic development from the formation of the zygote to the fetus. But developmental biology deals all the events from the day of formation of zygote to death of the person also. This is the embryology. Next branch of biology is genetics. Before going to that, how the question may be framed on embryology and developmental biology. How the question may be framed on embryology and developmental biology in NEET examination point of view means, if a student, wants to know, the sequential, stages of development of vertebrates, embryonic development, of vertebrates, then which branch of zoology helps to him? So how the question may be framed on this particular embryology and developmental biology concept in NEET examination point of view means, if a student wants to know the sequential stages of embryonic development of vertebrates, means so zygote, morula, blastula, gastrula, like this. If he wants to know what are the sequential stages of the development of embryonic development of vertebrate, then which branch of zoology a lot helps to him is the question. First option, taxonomy. Second option, embryology. Third option, genetics. Fourth option, morphology. So of these four options, which is correct one means embryology is the correct one, because embryology always concerned to deal all the events which may be occurs from the formation of the zygote to the delivery of the young one. This is the principal branch which may be deal all the fundamental events which may be occurs during the embryonic development from the day of formation of zygote to the delivery of the young one or infant or fetus. So that only sequential stages, nothing but zygote, morula, blastula, gastrula are the sequential stages in the embryonic development. So that only which branch a lot helps to him to betterly understand the sequential stages of embryonic development of vertebrates means embryology. That is the developmental biology and embryology. Next branch is genetics. Is the next branch of zoology. Genetics always deals with inheritance of characters and variations. So definitely genetics branch always concerned with two characters to betterly explain. One is the inheritance of characters, second one is the variation. What is the inheritance means? Due to the sexual reproduction, whatever the offsprings, whatever the young ones which maybe gets born to a couple of parent, definitely in that young ones, that parental characters must be appear. Passing of parental characters into the offsprings, passing of parental characters into the daughters is said to be as the inheritance of character. Definitely in all kind of the sexually reproducing individuals, definitely certain parental characters must be passed from the parents to the offsprings. That kind of the phenomenon is said to be as the inheritance of character. What is the reason to appear certain parental characters in daughters? What is the main reason to appear the parental characters in the offsprings? Means, definitely during the sexual reproduction, from the father's spermcell is gets releases. In the spermcell, definitely father DNA is present. Again, in the case of the or from the mother, ovum is gets releases. In ovum, mother DNA is present. Definitely during the sexual reproduction, from the father sperm cell is gets releases, from the mother ovum is gets releases. Definitely in the sperm cell father DNA is present, in the mother, in the ovum mother DNA is present. Whenever these two R gets fused to form the zygote, whenever these two R gets fused to form the zygote, into zygote father DNA is gets reaches, mother DNA is gets reaches. So that only whenever this zygote furtherly gets developed into daughter, definitely in daughter both parental characters must be appears. So that is said to be as the inheritance of characters. Definitely in all kind of the sexually reproducing organisms, in daughters definitely parental characters are appears. Means passing of parental characters into the daughters is said to be as the inheritance of character. Second, variations. Variations are nothing but though two children are born from the same couple, though two children are born from the same couple, 100% the two children are not with the identical, 100% the two children may not be with the 100% identical. They must be shows certain differences, at least in size of the body, in color of the body, in external morphology of the body. So such kind of the slight differences between the two children of the same parent is said to be as the variation. Genetics branch always deal how that kind of the characters are gets inherited into the offsprings from the parent, how that kind of the children are shows the differences, slight differences, though they may be gets originated from the same couple. That is nothing but variation. Means genetics branch always deals inheritance of the characters and also variation. The word of genetics is coined by Bateson. Bateson coined the word of genetics. Genetics word is coined by the Bateson.